Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the current affairs of today, that is 12th of March. So let's start the video. This is the schedule for the live classes. These are all free of cost, and take the screenshot and watch the classes accordingly. StudyIQ is also running the Big Holi Sale. This is for the best selling pen drive and Android courses. We have pen drive and Android courses. These are self-prep courses from which you can prepare from the comfort of your home, and the courses for more than 70 exams are available. So do check out our website studyiq.com for more details. Who has won the gold medal in 56 kilogram category at 38th Gi B boxing tournament? Who won the gold medal? It is Kavinder Singh Bisht. Kavinder Singh Bisht. This tournament took place in Finland. The capital of Finland, Helsinki, is where this tournament took place. Reserve Bank of India has imposed penalty worth 71 crore on how many public, private and foreign banks for non-compliance with the different SWIFT operations. 71 crore fine has been put on total 36 banks. 36 banks, these include banks like Bank of Baroda, HSBC, ICICI, SBI, Yes Bank, almost all the banks. And these, among these are public sector, private sector and foreign banks also. Who has been appointed as the next ambassador of India to the country called Republic of El Salvador? The capital of El Salvador is San Salvador, and the ambassador is Mr. B.S. Mubarak. Which country has launched the cooling action plan? The plan aims to have a goal to reduce the cooling demand across the sectors by 20% to 25% by the year 2037-38. So, India is the first country in the world to develop such a document, okay? And it wants to have cooling requirement across sectors. And the aim is what? Aim is basically to provide sustainable cooling and thermal comfort for all while securing environmental and socioeconomic benefits for the society. So, this is what is meant of cooling in this action plan. The answer is India. There is a 17.5 kilometer long road from Doimukh to Harmuti. It was in news recently. It will connect Assam and which state? It will connect Assam and Arunachal Pradesh. It's a new road that was inaugurated recently, and it was inaugurated by the Minister of State with independent charge of Development of Northeastern Region Department. So his name is Dr. Jitender Singh. Dr. Jitender Singh is the Minister for DONER. He inaugurated this road from Assam to Arunachal Pradesh. It is called Doimukh Harmoti Road. Which was the India's first intellectual property mascot? India's first intellectual property mascot was launched by CPAM, and it is called IP Nani. Let me show you intellectual property Nani. It was launched by CPAM. CPAM stands for Cell for IPR Promotion and Management. Which public sector company will acquire debt-laden Lanco's 500 megawatt Teesta hydroelectric power project for 907 crore in Sikkim? Teesta is also a river that originates from Sikkim. It also goes to West Bengal. The company that will buy it is NHPC. NHPC. Which cricketer was conferred with the Padma Shri Award for the year 2019? Padma Shri Award was given to Gautam Gambhir. So the answer is Gautam Gambhir. And Bharat Ratan, you know, was given to three people. One is Nanaji Deshmukh. He was RSS leader. Then we have Pranab Mukherjee, ex-president of India. And Bhupen Hazarika, the great singer from Assam. So, and Padma Shri was also given to actor Manoj Vajpayee for his contribution to cinema, Prabhu Deva for art and dance, Sunil Chhetri for sports, football, and cricketer Gautam Gambhir. And Padma Vibhushan was given to for Tijan Bai from Chhattisgarh for art, vocals, and folk. Ismail Omar Gule for public affairs in Djibouti. He is a foreigner. He got Padma Vibhushan. And Anil Kumar Nayak for trade and industry infrastructure. He's from Maharashtra. And Balwant Purandare, again from Maharashtra, for acting and theater. So we'll probably do a full video regarding the Padma Awards, where we'll do a compilation of all the Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan and Bharat Ratna in one video. So the answer is Gautam Gambhir. Who has been appointed new Prime Minister of Palestine? Recently, America, they closed down their embassy in Palestine because they want to have better ties with Israel. And new Prime Minister of Palestine is Mohammad Shatieh. Mohammad Shatieh. The Election Commission has formed a committee comprising three eminent observers to assess the situation in which state? This state is Jammu and Kashmir. So we also want to have the elections here. Now, in seven phases, the general elections will come up in many states. And therefore, in Jammu Kashmir also, the situation needs to be assessed. For that, there is a eminent committee. Which space agency will carry out the first all-female spacewalk on 29th of March? All-female spacewalk will be done by NASA. NASA. So NASA astronauts like Christina Koch and N.A. McLean, they will walk outside the International Space Station. Can you tell me who is the American space astronaut who holds the record for maximum spacewalks? She retired 2 years back. 14th, CII, Confederation of Indian Industry and Exim Bank, that is Export Import Bank of India, conclave on India-Africa project partnerships will be held where? It will be held in New Delhi. You also need to tell me who is the president of CII. Which country has won the first prize in the category of TV cinema spot at the prestigious International Golden City Gay Tourism Awards? Which country is this? It is India. The answer is India. Recently, one documentary called Period, End of Sentence, it won the Oscar for the best documentary. You need to tell me who is the director of this documentary, Period, End of Sentence. Confederation of Indian Industry has released a suggested election manifesto for political parties to achieve an average growth rate of how much percent per annum in the next 5 years. Suggested election manifesto says that political parties should have a growth rate of 8% over the next 5 years. According to the Asocham India data consumption report, India's data consumption is expected to grow at a compound annual growth rate of a whopping 72.6% by which year? India will achieve it by 2022. That is the compound annual growth rate of 72.6%. Manpreet Vohra has been appointed as India's next ambassador to which country? He has been appointed as an ambassador in the North American continent country, the southernmost country in the North America, which is Mexico. Who has been appointed as the new ambassador of India to Armenia? The new ambassador of India to Armenia is Kishan Dan Deval. Kishan Dan Deval. The new visa agreement has been signed between India and which country recently? This will make visa policies more liberal between the two countries. India has signed it with Maldives. Capital of Maldives is Male. Which of the following states is not located in the north? Jharkhand, Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Haryana. It's a relatively easy question if you are familiar with, well acquainted with the map of India. So it is Jharkhand. Jharkhand is not said to be in the north of India. Jammu Kashmir, of course, is the northernmost. Himachal Pradesh, which has a border with China. And then Haryana is also in north. In which state do we have a language? One of the main languages called Khasi. Khasi is a language in Meghalaya. Meghalaya. In which state will you find Elephant Falls? Elephant Falls are there in, it is on the outskirts of Shillong. So the answer to this question is also Meghalaya. Elephant Falls. Olympic medalist Kelly Catlin passed away at an age of only 23. She hailed from which country? She was an Olympic medalist. She was a cyclist from America. And she died at an age of 23. She, if you remember, she won silver medal in the cycling event in the 2016 Rio Olympics. So she passed away at age of 23. She was from America. India's first LGBTQ clinic and HIV treatment center was inaugurated in which city? It was inaugurated in Mumbai. It was inaugurated in Mumbai. So LGBTQ stands for lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender and queer. Which IIT in India has collaborated with Tirth? Tirth, it's a sustainable technology company to develop a device that can generate potable water from air. This IIT is the IIT Madras. So the answer is IIT Madras. Now before I say goodbye to you, here is a quick for banking awareness, especially for people who are giving banking exam like SBIPO. This is what you should remember, types of ATM. So white label ATM is owned by a non-banking financial company. Brown label ATM is owned by the bank, but its operation and maintenance is outsourced to a third party. Green label ATM is used for agricultural transactions. Orange label ATM is used for transacting shares. Yellow label ATM is used for e-commerce. And pink label ATM is used for women banking. So this was the video for today. I hope you liked and enjoyed it. There is always something to learn every day, every videos. There is always something to learn. So do watch these videos with utmost concentration and sincerity. So we are also running our holy sale. Let me remind you that this sale will run till 23rd of March midnight. You can make good use of it by buying any of the desired courses. Take care and see you tomorrow.